Hi, I'm Tim from Scoop, and welcome to our FBA series where we discuss the features, benefits, and applications of our favorite products. Today we're going to be discussing the MikroTik's HAPAC3, which is the latest home router series from MikroTik. Let's take a look and see what's inside the box. So inside the box, you'll find the HAPAC3. It looks like this. It's kind of more elongated when compared to the other HAP series range of routers. It's the same form factor as the HAPAC3 LTE6, which came out a couple months ago. So this is the router inside the box. It feels quite a bit heavier than the smaller generation of HAPs. You've got the two little detachable paddle antennas, which go directly onto the back. Of course, you've got the little stand, the desk stand, which allows you to orientate the router either in that sort of fashion. Alternatively, you can mount it this way, which I think would be the more popular choice for mounting. This will allow you to kind of attach the antennas in a fashion where they're kind of not in the way, something like that. If you've got it sort of orientated this way, the antennas take up quite a lot of room and might be a little bit in the way. So that's the antennas and the actual device. And we've got the mounting screws, which allow you to either mount this most likely onto a wall, not really onto a ceiling, but I suppose you could. And then we've got the 24-volt power supply that it ships with. So that's basically everything that's inside the box. Let's take a look at some of the features of this device. Looking at the features of this device, if we just turn it around here, we can see it's got 5 gigabit Ethernet ports in the back. It's got a PoE input on Ethernet 1 and a PoE output on Ethernet number 5. It's got the two SMA connectors, or reverse polarity SMA connectors, to allow you to screw on your antennas. It's got a USB port over here for additional storage. It's got this little button here called mode. This allows you to trigger scripts manually using this button when you configure it. It's got a reset button to allow you to reset or net install or boot up into your backup router boot. And there's also a little tag on the back here, which features your product serial number and MAC address information. There's also a QR code on here to allow you to scan and use the MikroTik app. On the front, there's another button, and this is for manually enabling WPS, or the WPS feature. We'd put the HAPAC3 between a RB-HAPAC² and 4011. It's got a quad-core CPU with 256 megs of RAM. This is all based on the ARM architecture, which is becoming more and more popular with MikroTik. One of the standout features of this device is it's got these detachable antennas. This has been missing from MikroTik's lineup for quite some time when it comes to home routers. So usually if you wanted to have a router that gave you wide coverage, you'd either have to use a router board 4011, which is usually overkill because it's designed for mainly business use, or you'd use an audience, but the audience is limited because it's only got 2 Ethernet ports. The other alternative would be to use an additional MikroTik access point, or CAP, so you end up using multiple APs inside your situation. With this device, hopefully you're going to get away with just installing one router and the antennas will do all the work for you. The antennas are dual band, 3 dBi on 2.4 and 5.5 dBi on 5 gigahertz, and they're attached with a little reverse polarity SMA, which is standard. This is really good for people, particularly in South Africa, because the buildings we have here are usually made out of brick and mortar, so it's usually difficult to get penetration out of the smaller HAP routers. Whereas this, I think, will give a lot more penetration and it'll be a lot more attractive for customers trying to get that extra penetration. As mentioned, this device has got a quad-core CPU. This is very appealing for anybody that's a power user or uses a lot of the features of router OS. So if you're one of the users that uses a lot of firewalls or you're doing a lot of QoS, the quad-core CPU and 256 megs of RAM is going to be ideal in your situation. Also, for anybody that's using power over Ethernet, so it's got PoE in at 18 to 28 volts and also PoE out. This is really good if you've got something like a wireless CPE or any other CPE that's compatible with between 18 and 24 volts. The target market for this router definitely leans towards the home user side of things, where clients want sort of wider coverage without installing too many devices. So from that aspect, it fits in really well. It also fits in if you're a more prosumer user, so you're taking advantage of more advanced features in RootOS, and I'm sure you'll be happy with the extra processing power inside. And finally, if you're a small business, I mean, this could be the ideal router for you. It's not quite a RB4011, but the specs are pretty close, and you should have no problems running this for a small business. As mentioned earlier in the video, there's also a version of this product that's got a built-in Cat6 LTE modem. This is going to be good for situations where you don't have fiber or any other wireless connectivity as your primary internet connection. Alternatively, it can be used as a redundant internet connection. The only downside is that it doesn't have the detachable antennas like this HAPAC3 does, so your Wi-Fi antenna coverage will be less. We think the new HAPAC3 is a fantastic addition to the range and look forward to your feedback in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. For more information on the products, see the links in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Tim from Scoop.